the ride itself. We put the most popular parks to the test, everything from the Big Dippers to the smallest rooms. And the verdict is clear. The best known will have to try much harder. Once inside, you're in their hands. Food, entertainment and comfort all depend on their standards. Britain now has 35 theme parks. We chose the top two, plus the new kid on the block. We start at Alton Towers, Britain's most popular commercial attraction. Today, it'll be subjected to a barrage of consumer tests. We'll measure the costs, the queues, and even the thrills using these special heart monitors. But the most important value for money indicator is a typical family. The Beckwiths, Jeff, Mandy, Greg, and Karen. They paid £62 to get in. It's the most expensive park in Britain. Make the trip to Staffordshire, and this is what you get. The whitest of knuckles. This ride, Nemesis, has a force four times greater than gravity. Heart rates rocketed to 170. 70 is normal. This ride goes faster than a Formula One racer. But this is where you're likely to spend more of your time in the rain, and it's much slower.
It's a theme park, but what's the theme? The only common link between the rides that I can see is queues. The chances are you'll spend a lot longer waiting in line than you will riding the attractions.
To get on the top five rides took 2 hours standing like this. For those waiting, there's no shelter, no entertainment, just the theme park version of a sheep pen. It's carefully laid out. When you think the queue's over, you turn a corner and there's more of it.
Mum, I'm not queuing up.
20% of the attractions are undercover. Storybook Land is new, and it was a hit with our youngest test pilot.
Looks so real!
This is an industry that thrives on innovation, but there are no new white-knuckle rides here this summer. Mealtime. Don't expect luxury. It's fast food and slow queues. Our family waited 20 minutes. Burgers and chips all round, £18. So, the verdict.
I like the Nemesis because it was really fast and went upside down and my heart rate went up to 170.
The queue for Nemesis, when we arrived there, was approximately 40 minutes. Now, that was the longest we had to queue, but I have heard of people having to queue for up to 2 hours.
Alton Towers has a slogan. The family suggest a change. Chessington World of Adventures in Surrey. It cost £59, £3 less than Alton Towers for our family of four.
What should we do first? Because I want to go for Forbidden Kingdom. That's where the
Mr. Keys, Magic Carpet.
There are 19 rides here. Alton Towers has more than twice that. For those rainy days, 18% of the rides are undercover. This is Ramesses Revenge. Great ride, lousy queues. 25 minutes here, 50 minutes at the neighbouring ride. No entertainment, no shelter, though you get good views of people already on board. The Beckwith's heart monitor said 143, higher than normal, but not matching the Alton Towers peak.
Once you've been on the ride, how about your photograph on the ride? Or the T-shirt of the ride, or the sweatshirt of the ride, or the bandana of the ride? All this cunning, themed merchandising can send your cost for the day sky high.
Mealtime. Again, it's munch on the move. Burger and chips for the family was more than a pound cheaper than at Alton Towers, £16.10.
A fork on a plate wouldn't go amiss, though.
This restaurant is supposed to be something special. Behind the curtains is an automated stage show, not working when we were there. The family went filming. At Alton Towers, the toilets were clean. Here they found smelly, messy toilets. One didn't flush properly, and there was litter.
What I thought let the park down was the cleanliness.
The food was nicer here than at Alton Towers, but because we didn't have any plates or knives and forks, it made the tables really greasy.
Legoland
in Windsor. It's the cheapest park we visited. £54 for the Beckwith family to get in. Others push their merchandise. Here the product link is everywhere. Chessington and Alton Towers both feel like American-style theme parks. This place has a very different pedigree, and that difference shows itself in some interesting ways. There's fruit and freshly made meals, not just fast food.
Oh, well, this is good. Something to do while we're queuing.
The queues have entertainment, games for all the family. The Scandinavian sense of humour is evident. Most of the attractions are hands-on, many are educational. Some are actually linked to the national curriculum. Here, youngsters learn road sense.
Does anyone know what that means?
Not even the smallest room is going to escape our scrutiny.
Just look at this, child-sized sinks and other facilities, and in the corner of the gents, a nappy-changing area, and in here, a baby seat. At mealtime, Legoland was the cheapest, £13.40, just under a fiver less than Alton Towers. There wasn't much for our heart monitors. This is about the most terrifying it gets.
Of course, what we all pay for at a theme park is fun, but has that message got through to the staff? Well, the answer to that one is written all over their faces.
And the answer is no.
If you want to experience a really good white-knuckle ride, you've got to go to Alton Towers. Unfortunately, you need more than one day.
I would go back to Legoland because it was so much fun.
We all had burgers and chips and a Coke, ice cream. At Legoland, you could have, the four of us could have that for under £20.
We think Legoland is the best value for money.
And some theme park tips. One, don't arrive at 11 o'clock. Everyone else seems to. Two, if you can, start at the back of the theme park and work your way forward. Most people do it the other way round. And three, give them a ring before you go.